Making a new website. First off, we're going to create a new folder. So right click, new folder, and we're going to call this website. You could call that the name of your website or anything like that, but for now we'll go website. In here, we're going to create a few folders so we can put our images and our additional pages in. So we're going to go right click, new folder, and we're going to call this images. We're going to right click, new folder, and we're going to call this pages. Now we're going to create our first page. So we'll right click, go new text document. So this is going to create our first page. So we'll go file, save as, and the first page is called index. So we'll go index.html for hypertext markup language. And then we go save as type and we go all files. And then we save that. We can then close that file and delete that new text document. Now we have our new empty HTML document. So what we'll do is we'll open that up. So we'll double click, we'll open that up and we'll see that there's absolutely nothing in there. So then we can right click on that and go edit with Notepad++, and that will open up. We'll then pull one to one side, one to the other side, and we've got them both on the page there. Now what we need to do is tell it that it is the HTML language. So we use these chevrons and we say HTML, and everything we open, we must close, like so. In here, we have a head and a body. In the head is the metadata. So that's all the stuff that's not directly displayed on the page. Again, everything we open, we must close. And then we have the body. Now, if I put some words on the page, save that, refresh that page, we can then see that that's on the page there. If I want to add more words down a bit, what I can do is I can do a BR, which is a break, which is like an enter, and then I can type my more words, save that, refresh, and you can see that more words are on the page. Notice how even though they're on the same line in the code, because of that break, it's putting it down a line. You can also do things like color. So if I wanted more words to be blue, I can use the font tag, so I can say font. Remembering everything that I open, I must close. So I'll also close font. And then I'll give it the attribute of color with the American spelling, and I will say blue. I will then save that and refresh, and now we can see that that is blue. If I wanted to put a heading on this page and tell it that this is the index page, I can do the H1, which is heading 1. So just think of the headings like in Microsoft Word. So this is heading 1, and I'm going to call this home page. Save that, refresh. We can now see that that's got the home page. Now, if I want home page in the middle, what I can do is I can use the center tag. So remember the American spelling. So center, close that. Save that and refresh. Now we can see that that's centered. Now, if I didn't close the center tag, everything would go with it. So if I cut that and save and refresh, you can see what I mean. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put that back. So I'm going to paste that back in, save that, refresh, and now only that stuff's in the middle there. Font also has another attribute called size. So in here I can do size, and I can say equals, and I can choose a number 1 to 7. So I'm going to choose 7 being the biggest. Refresh that, we can see that. Now if I chose the number 1, we can see that's the smallest one, and you'll see that just now. Now that we have our page created, what we could do is chuck an image on the page. So what we'll do is we'll quickly go to Google and find an image. In here we'll do an image search and grab a picture of that. Right click, save image as. Then we need to make sure that we're saving it in the folder that we created. So in here, I've got it on the desktop. So I'm going to go and find the desktop. And then I'm going to say my website and then images. Now I want to call this something meaningful. So I'm going to call this dog one. And notice how I do not have a space in that name. That's really important that you do not put the space in, otherwise you will have problems. Now if I minimize that, if I go into images, I can then see that dog one is there. I can double click on that to make sure that it's going to open and that it's going to be viewed all right. If I right click on that file and then go down to properties, I can then see that it is a .jpg. So I know that this is dog1.jpg. We're going to need that for later. So now when we come into here, we are going to add an image. So we say img for image, and then source. So src for source equals, and then where that is. So at the moment, we're on the index page. We need to go into images and then find dog1. So to go into images, we say images and then slash, and now we've got dog1.jpg. So now if we save that and refresh our page, we can see that we've got an image of our dog. If we wanted to make that smaller, we can do width equals. Now we can either give it pixels or a percentage. So if I said 50%, save that, refresh, you can see that it's resized to that, and it will change depending on how big my screen is. You can also put the height attribute in there as well. Now, if we wanted a link on there, so let's say that we wanted a link to Google, what we can do is we can use the anchor tag. So we say A, and then it has hyper reference. So href equals, and then the link where it's going to go to. So we'll put that in shortly. And then we close our anchor tag. Now, anything between the opening and the closing anchor tag is what's visible on the screen. So if we say link to Google, and then in here, we put http://www.google.co.nz, and then we save that and refresh. We will then see a link there to Google. Doesn't look very nice, so we're going to put a couple of breaks in here. So we're going to say br, save that, refresh. Now we've got our link to Google. When we click on that, it's going to take us to Google. Now what we can do is we can make a few more pages and link them together rather than going to an external page like Google. So we'll go back to our folder structure. In here we've got pages. So what we'll do is we'll make a page two. So we'll go new text document. We will right click on this. I will open this up, sorry. And then we will go file, save as. And we're going to call this page two dot HTML for hypertext markup language, and we're going to save this as all files. Save that, close that, and we can see that we've got page two there. We can then right click on that and go edit with Notepad++. You guessed it, now we've got to type in the code. Okay, now that we've got the basic code in there, we need to tell it that it's page two. So what we'll do is we'll give a heading one, and we'll close that heading one, and we'll call this page two. Save that. If we double click on that, we can see that we've got page two. Now what we're going to do is we're going to make a link between index page and page two. So what we'll do is we'll go to the index page and we'll go to the code on that. So we'll make sure that we're on the index page. And instead of this link to Google, what we're going to do is we're going to say from index. So from here, we want to go into the pages folder, and then we'll see page2.html. So we're going to take this out and we're going to say pages slash page 2 dot HTML. And then we're going to say page 2. Save that. Refresh that page. When we click on there, we can go to page 2. Now from page 2, we're going to need a link back to page 1. So what we'll do there is we'll have our anchor tag. So we'll go ahref equals, and we'll close our anchor tag. And in here, we're going to say home page. Now we need to get there. So if we have a look here, we're sitting on page 2. We need to go back to then see index. So there's a special piece of code that you say dot dot slash to go back out of that folder. So from here, going back is dot dot slash, and then we've got index.html. So we say index.html. Then we can save that, refresh that page. Now we can go back to the home page and to page 2. Now that we've got our links between the index page and page 2, we're now going to make a third page. So we'll go back to the website folder, go into pages, and now we'll make a page 3. What we can do this time is we can copy this one. So we can go copy and paste. Then we'll rename this and we'll say page 3. So say page 3, right click and edit with Notepad++. In here, we're going to make sure that we change that to page 3, save that, and then run that. If we click the home page, we can see it goes back to the home. We'll then click back, but we can't get to page 2. So we need to tell it that we want to get to page 2. So we're going to do another anchor tag. So we'll go ahref equals. And in here, we'll say page 2. Now, what we need to do is we need to say from page 3, we're going to page 2. It's in the pages folder, so we don't need to go anywhere. So we just say page 2 dot HTML. We save that, refresh that page, and now we can get to page 2. So now all we need to do is go to page 2 and do the same to page 3. So go ahref equals, and we're going to say from here, it's right there. So we're going to say page 3. HTML, and we're going to say page 3. Save that, refresh, and we can go from 3 to 2 back to the home page. Now we'll go back to the index page and we will add a page 3 link. So what we're going to do this time is we're just going to copy this and we are going to paste it in. And we're going to change the page 2 to page 3 and page 2 to page 3. Save that, refresh that, and now you can see that all of the pages link up. If we want to add that image onto page 2, we can go to page 2 and we will add that image. So we'll put a BR here for a break, and then we're going to add that image. So we'll go IMG space SRC for source equals, and then where that is. Now, if we go to pages, we can see that page 2 is sitting here. We need to go back a folder and then into images. So we'll go back a folder dot dot slash and then images, and then we can see dog 1. And then if we right click on this, go back to properties, and we can see that it's .jpg. So dog1.jpg. Save that, refresh that, and we can see that we've now got the dog on the other page.